Hello everybody, and we continue our chess video lessons. Today I prepare something very interesting. I hope you will like it. This is some variation, Ruy Lopez defense exchange variation. But what is important, what we will watch, this is some pawn endgame and pawn structure in Ruy Lopez defense. Ruy Lopez is coming with bishop b5. This is the most popular opening when somebody play e4. And the main variation is a6. And now exchange variation is bishop c6. Pawn takes c6. And here I want to show you something interesting. What's happened in pawn structure, and what's happened after we change this pawn? And now we can see that white has four pawns on the king side, and black has only three pawns on the king side. But on the queen side, black has one pawn more, but black has double pawns on c7 and c6. And these double pawns, they are not so good. And what is for today, what is the theme of this lesson is pawn endgame in Ruy Lopez defense. Pawn endgame, when we take all pieces from the board, then we will get position like this. And this position, we can say that it's better for white. In some old book, I read some Russian chess book, Chess Academy, there was written that white is completely winning here, that this position is winning for white. Of course, without king, a king is there is very good for black, because king will make some to protect some squares and doesn't give white to go forward. But without kings, black white easy make a passed pawn. Okay, this position is very interesting, and you have to know that this is winning for white. Okay, but we have first some position like this one, just that you know how you have to stop black pawns on the queen side, because there are four pawns against three pawns, but they are stopped. For example, white can play just f4, and white make this form with his pawns a3, b2, c3. And this is very important. Black cannot make progress without his helping of his king. The pawns cannot make progress alone. But on the king side, white pawns can make progress if there are not kings on the board. Okay, we will see. For example, if black play b4, white doesn't have to touch anything, just keep this position and just to play king f2. And then three pawns on the queen side, they block four pawns. But for example, what will happen if white make mistake and take to b4? This is not good. Now, double pawns are not double anymore, and there are three pawns against two. Black will try to make progress. For example, this is also not good to take the pawn, then is losing, because black is quick to make promotion of his pawn. And then a pawn is near to promote a square, and black take the queen. Black is fast. And for example, here, If white doesn't take to b4, he can play king f2. But then black has excellent move, c3. And now if pawn takes to c3, then we can see also that black pawns is far away and king cannot catch this pawn. It means that he has to go maybe with king, but then black just take here and promote into the queen. But the main thing here is just to wait and not to do anything, and three pawns, they don't give four pawns on the queen side to make any kind of progress. For example, if black takes to a3, white takes, and we can see that these pawns, they are blocked. They cannot go forward. Or if, for example, black play b3, then these pawns are also blocked. And now, what is interesting, now white is playing on the king side. And queen side is blocked, this is important, and king side is not blocked. And white has pawn more on the king side, he will push his pawns and he will make progress. On the end, white king will come to d5 and take black pawns on the queen side. Then it means white is winning. But what you have to know? You have to know just that pawns a3, b2, c3, don't move them and they will block four pawns. But we have some different structure. For example, this one, where we can also play f4 and then a2, b3, c4. They can also block these four pawns, but don't touch anything. If black take to c4, then we will take, or if black change something, but we don't want to do anything special. For example, black can take, we can take, and this is a block on this side. Or if black play something like a3, we don't do anything, we just go with king forward. For example, if white take here, then this is not good. Black pawns become good on king f2, c4, and now if white make big mistake, then black can play b4 and then black can win the game, because pawn sacrifice when you take, and then a2 and black promote the queen. But okay, here white has only move to save the game, and this is move b4, but b4 just doesn't give white anything. It can be draw, I think, because white has e pawn, what is very important, but black has protected passed pawn, and I think both players will not make progress, and then just it will be draw. But for example, here we have to know that nothing to touch for white, and then we just play with the king. We are going to make progress on the king side. This is very important. And king e3, we will push e5, f5, maybe g4, h4, king there, how wish you. But white is playing to win the game on the king side. Okay, and then we come back to this position, but this position to get from the beginning of the game, it's not so easy. Then you have to change all pieces, and to change all pieces you have to play. But there are so many games in Mega Database, and a lot of games finished like this, that players just played this kind of endgame. And here, black will try also with the king to keep some squares and not try not to lose. But we will see what's happened if in this position there are not kings on the board. And we can see here that white is much better, and e-pawn will be promoted into the queen. And without kings on the board, white is completely winning. Okay, just need first to show you how. You just stop black on the queen side and then goes with all pawns, just to make some passed pawn. For example, here black cannot stop white to make progress in the center, because 4 pawns against 3, it's too much, and then white is winning. For example, here, and then just queen side is block, and white promote into the queen. Or maybe if in this position black wants to stop white pawns and just to play h5, but he cannot stop anything. White will play g3 and then e5, and after g6, now h3 pawn will help, and then slowly white will make progress on this side. And we can see that after this, white doesn't have to touch anything on the queen side, just play where he is better, but he is better on the king side. And on the end, after this, then white has passed pawn. Okay, in a normal chess game, there are kings on the board, then white will win easy. But here without king also, just take the queen, and this is it's not stalemate. This is not really without kings on the board. Yes, and then you can see that this pawn structure, it's not so good. And always just think to go into the pawn endgame, and pawn endgame is winning for white. Okay, here we have this position with white on the move. I will show you some kind of my analyze how white is playing and win the game. Okay, we concentrate our mind on the king's side, because what will happen, it will happen on the king's side. And we have to be sure that we will stop black to play on the queen side. King e7, g4, f6, h4, c5, and we go up with our king. King e3, king d6, and here I will show you first idea to stop black pawns on this way with e3. And a3 and c3, and here white just think how he will make passed pawn, or how he will make some way with his king to go forward, to go in, to cross the middle of board. This is important. And for example, black, if he plays king c5, but king is going on a wrong side, this is not good. f5, king d6, and king f4. And white is waiting black just to move the king and then to play e5 and then to take to f6, then to play g5 and to make some passed pawn on the king side. Black is doing something like c6, and in many similar positions, white sacrifice the pawn with e5, and why he is doing this, because after this he will come king e4, and he is waiting one moment. Black has to move his king and he will lose on e5. But what's happened if he doesn't move the king? He's playing a5, for example, and now white can do something like h5. Wants to play g5 and to make progress on the king side. Black stop this, and we have some position like this, where white can try to make some progress with his pawn, and on the end this pawn will be promoted into the queen. And you have to remember, or white doesn't have to hurry, white has to do something, also some moves, but he's this one who is playing to win. For example, black play c5, then f5, king e5, then king f3. And we are waiting that black lose some tempo. And black is doing something. We play king e3. a5, king f3, b3, king e3 or a4. Doesn't matter. And some moment, black has to play with king back. This is very important, and then king f4. King is going down, e5, king here, then take this pawn here, and g5. And we can see white make progress on the king side, and this is very important in our lesson about this position. Okay, you can try many different ways to win, but this is something what you have to know. First, how to block black. You can do sometimes something like this, c4, but black to take on c4, this is very bad. How it can be good? Then he has three pawns on the same file, and just king d2, and king is going to c3 and c4 to take. For example, king e6, but black has also interesting option g5, just to make some space to come with the king to e5. But we can see that white has protected passed pawn on f5, and then it means black cannot take to e4. And what to do? This is just winning for white. And it's important white king is there. If something happened on the king side, he can quickly go king d3, king e2, and to protect position. But here, for example, king e6, king c3, and black just doesn't have any kind of serious moves to protect his position. He can try also something like this, but then f5 here, king c4, and maybe black try h5, but just take this, and after g5, king can catch this pawn, and this pawn cannot go forward. But white has a lot of passed pawns. This is very important, and how black can play against this. And it means that here to take on c4, it's not so Good, but okay, maybe white should first play, maybe b3 to play c4, but c4 is interesting. And we can see what's happened if king e6, then here white can just take here and then play a3, and then wants to play b3 and a4. And black cannot stop this because on c4 king d4 is coming. For example, this, then b3, king e6, a4. And after taking, then white will have two passed pawns, what black king cannot stop them. This is very important. But then it means that on c4, black can play maybe b4, but then b3, king e6, king f3, c6, king e3, and white is waiting a little that black lose all his moves, to lose all his tempo, and then white will do his action on the king side. But okay, black can also say, I don't want to to push my pawns. I will play king d6, something like this. But then, okay, white will not wait anymore. He has to make some action on the king side. G5, king e6, f5. In many cases, white will play something like this and give black e5. But when you give black the square e5, you just need to play king f3, king e3. These two moves you have for your king until black lose all his moves with his pawns. When he lose his moves, he must go with king back. This is important. But here we will see what's happened if he goes forward. But just to go king d4, then king f4, and h5, and here king is on d4. This is not good. Then white has e5. Pawn takes, and now very important move is king g3. Then if he goes king f3, then e4 is coming with the check. But now there is no e4 with check, and then f6. And black cannot stop white pawn, but white king can stop black pawn. This is important. Then king f2, and white is winning. And we can see this is so nice how black cannot do anything. a5, g5. And now, okay, there are some more options. One option maybe to take to g5, but just pawn takes. And here we can see that white has passed pawn in the center, and black, if he tries something like this, just take en passant and king f3, and king is going on h-file to take this pawn, and white is better. And because of this, black can try something like f5. And now for white to push e5 is not good. Then everything is blocked and it will be draw. Doesn't matter because of passed pawn. You have to be very careful in some position that don't make black to block position. h5, maybe g6, we can play h6, and then what to do with the black pieces? Now he has to do something. If he takes to e4, king takes, king move, then f5 is coming. And for example, here white don't play e5, then it will be draw. But in this case, white is completely winning. White is going just on another side. Here, okay, now black is in Zugzwang, something like this, where to play. He has to stop white to come to h5, but he cannot do this. On king h5, just king h3, waiting move, and then he has to go back. Or something like this, also waiting move with king h3. This is important, but okay, you can go also here. You want to go king h5, but on this move, then you have some kind of triangulation. You need to win or to lose the tempo. This is very important. And then after this, king d, king g3 here, and then king h4. And this is the same. And now white is winning because black is on the move. But of course, also if white is on the move, white will win with move g6. This is also very easy, but we will go here. Then here white plays king h3, king g6, king h4, king back, and then king h5. And now what to do? Okay, he moves there, then g6, pawn takes, king takes here, and king f5. And we can see that for black to make something is very, very hard. If white makes some mistake, then black will maybe play draw. But if white play in good way, then black chance to make draw are very small, and we can see, I think this for this kind I like a lot, but also a2, b3, c4, this is also very good. And just white is playing to win the game, and because of this, it's very nice that you have to know if you play opening Ruy Lopez, then you can try to change all pieces on the board and then to play the endgame. For example, this endgame, white to move, white play and win. This is some similar, and white just need to know important rule in this endgame that sometimes, maybe not sometimes, maybe always, you have to know that to give the pawn and then to make some waiting move and wait to go with your king forward. If black doesn't do anything, then you have passed pawn, what you will give to your opponent, and then your king will be very active, and then position is winning, because black king is so passive, cannot protect anything. He's going on the king side, but we don't want to take pawns on the queen side first. We can just wait here and wants to take h5 pawn, and then we will go back. Black cannot do anything, just black has to wait, and now king is going on another side and take all black pawns, and white is easy winning in this position. Then it means that if you like to play Ruy Lopez opening, just try to change all pieces on the board and to play pawn endgame. And you will see how it's easy to win pawn endgame with this pawn structure, with the double pawn on the king queen side for black. I hope you learned something new from this video, and see you soon. See you with my next chess lesson. Until this, bye bye.